cooking. Looking. What? You got cooking.
Much of today's advertising is directed at women. That's because of our vast spending power. Many of us go out to work, and even those who don't run homes and have the responsibility of managing the household budget. This programme is concerned with one of the most enduring images to emerge in advertising this century, the woman in the kitchen.
Get out in that kitchen and rattle those pots and pans.
A large proportion of all advertising is devoted to household products, all the things you need for the mundane tasks of cooking, cleaning and washing. None of these activities are particularly exciting in themselves, so advertisers have built up a sort of mythology around them to help sell the products. They've portrayed the kitchen as a sort of combination temple, palace and showroom, with the woman at the centre.
The world of the woman who lives in her kitchen has changed a great deal since advertisers first focused on it over a century ago. We have given up servants. Advertising now speaks directly to us. We use the products, not hired help. And our lifestyle has changed too. The time we spend in our kitchen has drastically shrunk in the second half of this century. But has the advertising world really taken account of the changes in women's lives and attitudes in the way that it depicts us?
With the shortage of domestic help, labour-saving kitchens are the plan of the future.
In 1950, women ran their homes in much the same way as they had done a century before. But the decade after the war saw a revolution in the kitchen.
All the drudgery will be taken out of it in the home of tomorrow by a simple turn of a switch.
There were the new gadgets and machines.
No more rubbing boards and washerwoman's hands when a gadget like this can do it all for you.
And the lifting of higher purchase restrictions in 1954 signalled the beginning of a new era of conspicuous consumption. Sales of electric cookers and refrigerators boomed. We went gadget mad. And along with the new gadgets, there were new products that completely changed life in the home. New detergents and washing powders. In 1955, ITV arrived with a new form of advertising that went right into the home and nearly into the kitchen itself. Advertisers took the task of constructing the new image seriously. A trade paper gave them advice claiming authority begins at 40, so we saw a lot of older mums. The kitchen was suggested as a believable location.
Rise and shine! Good work on an egg.
So an advertising image was born, and the idea was fully developed in the early 60s.
Just a few pennies ahead, but you'll keep them quiet all morning. With any luck. Nice, nourishing, economical.
Though the surroundings may seem realistic, the portrait of the woman is anything but.
Oh, am I glad to see you, Mrs. M. Bill's mother's oh, no.
She is never portrayed as having a credible identity or life of her own.
But you want a nice bucket of flash.
Instead, she seems to be plagued by nagging anxieties which hinge on her kitchen activities. She feels she has to get things right, and that, of course, depends on buying and using the right products.
Is she a good cook? The meat's perfect. Look how tender it is. So are the potatoes. But here's where you can really judge the tastiness, where it matters most. In the gravy.
Cooking became a ritual whereby the woman exerted control over the rest of the family and won applause and love. Cooking was and is portrayed as the route to a man's heart and the children's affections. Cooking equals caring, and any family problem can be solved by providing the right brand of food, from breakfast cereal to beans.
She's eaten them up. What a beautiful sight. She's bounding with energy morning and night. Her writing's superb and her spelling is bright. And what's even better, she gets her sums right.
Kellogg's Sugar Frosted Flakes put sparkle into children at breakfast time.
A million housewives every day pick up a tin of beans and say, beans mean kind.
And if Frosted Flakes could solve educational problems in 1955, why shouldn't beans stop your children running away in 1967?
Go round the world tomorrow instead.
Well, I get up about 10 minutes past six in the morning, and then it's father's turn to get up. They have to wait on them hand and foot, haven't you?
These advertisements presented their product as the key to a happy family life.
Just trying to remember who likes it hot, who likes it cold, who likes it warm.
Some were almost like short documentaries.
Little rabbit. But if they have a dish of cornflakes for breakfast, you know, I realise they're all right until dinner time.
Someday we'll build a home.
Many advertisements connected with cooking created cosy scenes of wedded bliss.
You and I, shiny.
One of the most famous campaigns ever was constructed round a particular woman in the kitchen, keeping her man happy.
I'm Katie. I like Oxford recipes. They tell you exactly how to make quite ordinary things exciting to eat.
Katie took over the job of selling Oxo from Sooty.
Mince, tomato, big potatoes. Nice and cheap, this.
For over 20 years, she created meals with man appeal for husband Philip.
9 different ingredients, the ones men like. Yes, and they were very pleased with him at the clinic. Last week he gained a whole half pound.
Honestly, Katie.
Although they moved from a small house to a larger one in the country, had a son and even went to America, Katie always did the cooking.
I hope it'll be all right.
Oh, I'm sure it will, ma'am.
Gee, ma'am, I never tasted beans this good before.
That's quite something coming from a real cowboy.
Things have changed since Katie's day.
You can't go out without a decent meal.
But I've only got 5 minutes. It is for occasions such as these that...
Now convenience foods can win a husband's approval.
Ready in a tick, dear.
Even if he's not quite the man that Philip was.
But it's when it comes to washing and cleaning that the woman in the kitchen really enters an arcane world of magic and ritual.
The grubbier the job, the more magical the product that will release the woman from drudgery. White tornadoes can be conjured up.
Good heavens, it's a white tornado. Mary, that's a white tornado.
I know. I just bought it. New Ajax all-purpose liquid cleaner with ammonia. See how it cuts right through the grease? So quick.
Worktops like glisten and ping. Dirty floors and ovens are magically transformed.
Brilliant.
Mmm, smells lovely and fresh.
And there are all sorts of spells and secret signs.
Brilliant.
So too with the laundry. The woman in the kitchen is judged by her washing, and this can generate severe anxiety. To achieve close-up cleanliness, she must overcome some awesome enemies. Tea stains, grease, dried-in blood. Success in the battle depends on enlisting the aid of powerful allies. The new magic of technology can be relied on in the crusade. Have always been on hand to help out the embattled woman in her struggle for the perfect wash. After all, it's their manly expertise that has developed the tools for the job and created those miracle-working powders. In many TV commercials, it's a male voice that patiently helps the woman through a process she obviously couldn't manage on her own. Success in getting the wash right is an enormous relief. The ritual properly accomplished wins praise from the whole family. The message is simple. Can you afford not to care?
Today we spend a lot of money on the home and on luxury fitted kitchens. No mess, sophisticated modern living. The ads are glossier and more glamorous, but the woman at their centre has remained the same. The penny may have given way to designer jeans, but she is still shown as dependent on her magical aids and disembodied male advisors to get her through her day. The fixtures and fittings in the kitchen may have changed, the products may have changed, but it's the same woman trapped in there.
Stay as sweet as you are. Don't let a thing ever change you. Stay as sweet as you are. Don't let a soul rearrange you. Young and gay are old and gray. Near to me are afar. Night and day I pray that you'll always stay as sweet as you are.